Stormy seas and lost souls. She's dreamt of this before. They say dreams are visions of our memories, thoughts and fears, as seen by our inner eye. But what if each one of us is always dreaming, even when awake, and we only see what our inner eye creates for us? Is this what hell is? A world shaped by Senua's nightmares? Maybe that's why people feared seeing the world through her eyes. Because if you believe that Senua's reality is twisted, you must accept that yours might be too.
You failed the gods. You're pathetic. Rotten. Cursed. What were you thinking? Did you really think you could win? How stupid can you be?
So stupid.
Everyone hates her. She's cursed.
The shadow hates.
Look at you. A warrior. Worthless. Weak. Pathetic. Go on. Feel sorry for yourself, because there's no one left to do that for you. Take it. If you're too much of a coward to fight, then end the suffering. Broken and lost. Just
do
like
it.
Your
Go
sword.
On, come on. Dare.
Nein. Oh boy.
Why go on? When you give everything and face that which torments you, only to find that it is worse than you could have imagined. Why go on? Is it really so weak to ask this? Or are we just so afraid of the honest answer that we do not dare pose the question? Sometimes the answer lies in a memory, a feeling. A song.
It's not real. It's a trick. It's not real. It's real. Listen to it.
She can't give up.
Did it?
It's not like this.
It's not real. It is real. It's a trick. Don't trust it. Maybe you're already dead.
Who are you?
Do you still believe in yourself?
Hey, den Kampf haben wir vielleicht verloren, aber ich glaube, der größten Kampf, den wir führen, ist der Kampf mit uns selbst. Und den haben wir noch nicht verloren und den werden wir nicht verlieren. Denn die Liebe steht über allem. Mal kurz gucken, gibt es hier noch was? Eine Rune oder so? Wir wollen ja alle mitnehmen.
Where are you going? See, there's nothing to fall. Come on.
Wir schaffen das. Ich habe keine Ahnung wie, aber wir werden das schaffen.
Bevor sie ihn zuerst kennenlernte, sie war nicht in einem guten Platz. Just a teenager, but not like the others. Barely functioning, she rarely left the house. Her father, Zinbel, made sure of that. Only occasionally did she venture out on her own, collecting firewood and herbs. Errands out in the Orkney Plains. That was her world. Like this one. Barren. And lonely.
So, ich will mich hier ganz genau umschauen. Na? Ich denke mal, wir müssen grundsätzlich dahin. Also da hinten in die Höhle. Aber ich möchte hier auch nichts verpassen. Na, okay, hier gibt's wohl nichts. Vielleicht auch das Boot hoch. Ja, eigentlich das Boot hoch. Aber ich guck mal, was hier gibt. Ah, seht ihr?
Senua, there will be times that you will feel alone and exhausted, like a strange little fish swimming against the tides of the big ocean. But have the faith to let go and let the tide carry you away. Because the whole ocean is your home, and it does not ask you to swim against it.
Hey, hier geht's nicht weiter. Komm schon, Senua, wir schaffen das. Wir sind schon sehr weit gekommen, denke ich. Hör nicht auf die Stimmen, ich bin die einzige gute Stimme.
One day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever can release it. Many try, but the sword only comes out at Sigmund's touch. His brother-in-law, King Siggeir, wants it, but Sigmund refuses him, so King Siggeir plots revenge. He invites Sigmund and his brothers to a feast, but when they arrive, they are met with an army, not a warm welcome. King Siggeir captures Sigmund and his brothers, steals his coveted sword, and readies them for execution.
Hey. Ich finde das richtig klasse, dass mir die nordische Mythologie so ein bisschen dabei kennenlernen. Richtig, richtig gut. Deswegen wäre es auch schon richtig gut, alles mitzunehmen an diesen Runen.
death for Sigmund and his brothers seems certain. But the king's wife is Sigmund's sister, and she begs for mercy and implores the king to chain them up instead. He agrees. Not for mercy, though, but because he plans an even more cruel and lingering death. Chained to a tree in the forest that night, a she-wolf comes and devours one of Sigmund's brothers. She returns, ravenous, night after night, until only Sigmund is left. The next day, Sigmund's sister sends a servant with honey to smear on Sigmund's face. But to what end? Well, that night, when the she-wolf appears again, you'll never guess what happens.
Ja, was passierte? Mann! Ich will mir da hinten noch schnell was anschauen. Hier oben. Wir müssen zwar zum Baum. Aber das ist ja hier irgendwie auch begehbar. Geht das hier wohl nicht? Nach vorne ist auch eine Leiter gewesen. Ah ja, da wäre noch eine Rune. Also müssen wir wieder hier zurück, wahrscheinlich. Ich denke, wir müssen erst später wieder zurück. Aber das weiß man ja nie in den Spielen. Ja?
As the she-wolf licks the sweet honey from Sigmund's face, he bites the wolf's tongue. The she-wolf pulls away, but Sigmund holds on. The chains break, and he is free. After his escape, Sigmund lives like us, hidden in the forest. His enemy, King Siggeir, believing him dead, as his sister plots revenge. And for vengeance to succeed, even the great Sigmund needs help. So she sends her sons to him. But their blood is weak and corrupted, and they're put to death by Sigmund. So his sister hatches a new plan, one that is cold of heart and pure of blood.
Okay, möchte ich wissen, wie die Geschichte ausgeht? Gerade weiß ich's nicht so. Es wirkt so ein bisschen, als hätte man in dieser Geschichte die Wahl zwischen schlecht und schlecht. Als gäbe es diesen typischen Guten nicht. Ist hier was? Hier sieht nicht so aus. Wir müssen nach hinten. Aber hier haben wir nichts verpasst, ne? Da waren wir. Oh, da waren wir. Okay. Tut mir leid, wenn sich der Part jetzt ein bisschen zieht. Aber es war echt schade, was zu verpassen.
Day after day, watching from afar, she mimicked him, perfecting her own secret dance.
wishing those fleeting moments of light would stretch out to last forever.
Sigmund's sister trades shapes with the sorceress, and in disguise, she lies with her own brother. She gives birth to a son named Sinfjotli. After a time, she sends him to the forest to Sigmund. He tests the boy and finds him strong and fearless, and so they go to take their vengeance on King Siggeir. Luck is not on their side. They're captured, and Siggeir has them buried alive.
Geschichte wird nicht besser. Also.
What's your name?
Senua.
I haven't seen you before.
I'm not. I don't leave home much.
Oh. Zeno's daughter.
I have to go.
Wait. Who taught you to fight like that?
No one.
No one?
Well, I watched you. And.
You. Learned all of that from watching me? You should become a warrior, you know.
Me?
I'm Dillian. I'm here for the warrior trials. Just come and watch. And bring your sword.
You can't put it into words. That moment when you look into the eyes of the one who's supposed to reassure you. Make you feel safe. It only takes an instant. Fear swallows you before you have a chance to make sense of it. And darkness becomes a part of who you are.
You killed him.
But her world changed the day the Northmen took him from her. Senua knows that there's no going back to how things were. That there's nothing to go back to at all.
Stay still, stay quiet, hide, and don't hurt.
Their gods can see into your mind. They will use this power to destroy you.
They won't stop me. I can still feel him.
Whatever's left of him, they will never let him go.
I'm not gonna let him rot here.
You're the one rotting here.
Leave me alone.
You will die here.
No.
And all your suffering will have been for nothing.
Shut up! You won't survive.
You met him by the tree.
Nein, doch nicht. Das sieht so aus, doch.
He's waiting for you by the tree.
Na gut, dann doch die andere Richtung. Jetzt? Oder müssen wir später auf der Rücktour? Okay. Aber das sieht doch gut. Ja.
As Sigmund and Sinfjotli are being buried alive, Sigmund's sister throws an armful of straw into the grave mound. Hidden in the straw is Sigmund's sword, the gift of Odin. They cut their way out of the grave mound and set fire to Siggeir's hall. The king burns to death. Sigmund calls to his sister to come out so that she may live and be honored. She does come out, but only to tell him the truth. That she had slept with him, her brother, to beget a strong avenger. I am not fit to live, she says, and walks back into the fire. Strike vengeance from your heart, Senua, as there is always a heavy price to pay.
Ja, ich glaube, diese Moral sollten wir uns alle merken. Krasse Geschichte. Krasse Geschichte, du. Hier noch?
Here is the end of Sigmund's story. He was a fierce and great warrior who fought many battles. But one day, an old man came onto the battlefield. Although shadowed by a hood, Sigmund saw that he only had one eye. The man raised his spear, and Sigmund struck at it with his sword, but the sword shattered into pieces. Sigmund then knew that this was Odin, and thus that victory could not be his. He bowed his head and accepted his end. Dying, he tells his wife that she is with child and that her son will one day make a great weapon out of the fragments of his sword. The sword named Gram.
Das Schwert holen wir jetzt. Zufällig. Da ist noch, aber jetzt müssen wir auch. Ja, ich denke, wir haben alles mitgenommen. Hier wieder. Da geht's ja auch nur zurück. Okay.